Now, if you play Black Ops 4, then all of you should know that there is a new operation, and this one is called Grand Heist. Now, as you can see, I have been playing a little bit, but I'm just going to go through all of the tiers, 1 to 100. So let's not waste any of your time, and let's just get into it. So for the first tier is Outrider, a new specialist, back from Black Ops 3. It's the one with the bow and arrow. Looks alright. And then tier 2, you get this like crown reticle for your guns, for your reflex sight. Tier 3, you get a war paint, which actually looks quite good. Tier 4, you get a dance called Payday. It goes along with the heist theme. Tier 5, you get... Okay, so it's a wingsuit trail. Okay, I didn't realise that. I didn't know what it was. Tier 6 is a money bag emblem. Tier 7 is a calling card. Tier 8 is another emblem. Tier 9, another calling card. Tier 10 is an outfit for the Outrider. And I think there's one of these for every single specialist. And they all look really good because they're animated, and they're animated in game as well, so. Yeah, I'm really excited to get these. Tier 11 is another emblem. Tier 12, another emblem. 13, a calling card. 14 is an emblem, or sticker, whatever. And tier 15 is a outfit for Seraph, which looks really nice. But in fact, it's got the money bag with the blue on it. Colour of blue looks really, really nice. Tier 16, we've got another emblem sticker. We've got another emblem on 17. Calling card on 18. Another emblem on 19. On 20, we get this gun. Let's play the video. It looks really nice. Animated as well. Now, 21 is another calling card. 22, an emblem. 23 is another emblem. There's loads of emblems. All to do with like money and bank robberies. Another calling card. Now, this is really, really cool. It's like a melee weapon, but it's a bag of money. As you can see, when you hit people, all the money comes out. And this is only on tier 25 as well, so most people should get this. Whoops. 26 is a calling card. Number 27 is a really cool emblem. I'll be using that. And 28 is another dance. Playing with a megaphone. 29 is another calling card. Here's the baller outfit for Profit. Looks really nice. And here's another sticker, emblem, whatever. Another emblem sticker. Here's the pomegranate. Doesn't look too good, but some people might like it. 34 is another emblem. Number 35 is a camo. Another emblem. Yeah, another emblem. Calling card. Emblem. This really, really cool one. It's like a juggernaut. It's one of the cooler ones for Firebreak. Another sticker. Another calling card. Another sticker. Another sticker. Now this is really cool. It's the Warden or Brutus, whichever you want to call it, from Mob and Blood of the Dead. Really, really cool character. And you can actually play this in Blackout. Another calling card. Here's a baller outfit for Zero. It's another emblem. Not an emblem, sorry. An emote. Dance, whatever. Playing the air guitar. Another calling card. And we're halfway there. This is a shotgun. Play the video. Reminds me a lot of the Haymaker or Brekkie from Black Ops 3. It's the way that it shoots. Right, and tier 51 is another war paint, face paint, whatever. There's another one. All in. It's like a ace of spades. Not spades, sorry. I can't remember cards. A heart attack one for Valentine's Day, I believe. There's another calling card. Here's the baller outfit for the Firebreak, which I think is brilliant. Because the colour purple on here, the animation on here looks really, really nice. Another emblem. Another calling card. There's so many in this pass. Tier, whatever you want to call it, contraband. King of Space. Emblem. Here's another camo. This one looks sick. That's really cool. Right, 61. Another calling card. 62. Another emblem. 63. Another calling card. 64. Another emblem, and here's the baller outfit for Ruin. This one looks alright. It's a bit like the Zero one with the green. Another emblem. Another emblem. Another calling card. Another emblem. Now this outfit, I really, really like this one. Just because it's like really different. Like the other ones, they usually keep like the same sort of outfits on. But for him, they've removed like lots of things. They've given him like hair, glasses, like a bag on his back. It's one of the best outfits. Maybe even the best in this whole pass. Tier 71 is another remote gesture. Another emblem. Another calling card. Another emblem. I think this one's quite cool as well, yeah. It's for the Auger DMR. That is really nice. And it's got lights on it as well. Tier 76. Another emblem. 77, another emblem. 78, a calling card. Another emblem. Another war paint, face paint. Another emblem. Calling card. Another emblem. It's another emblem. There's so many emblems. I think they should like add more concepts just to like add up all of the slots, because they obviously couldn't think of much, so they just put loads and loads of emblems. Here's the baller outfit for Recon, which is golden, reminds me of the gold specialist from Black Ops 3. Looks really, really nice. Another emblem. Another calling card. Another emblem. Another emblem. Nah. That's very good. Outfit for Outrider. 10 more tiers left. That looks cool. It's a sorg on a stack of money. Emblem. Calling card. Emblem. Emblem. Calling card. Emblem. Emblem. Calling card. There is honestly too many. Another emblem. And the last tier is this SMG. Looks alright. So that is this whole pass. Now if you look at just below the pass, I'll show you how many of each like thing there are, like how many outfits, emblems, calling cards, dances, like war paints, basically everything in here. There'll be like how many there are just down here. So I'll give you a minute to look at that before we move on to the next thing. So yeah, that's just all of the contraband, pass, tiers, whatever you want to call them. So yeah, let's move on to the next thing. Right then, the next feature that they added in was, again, in the black market. They have added in reserves, which are basically supply drops from Black Ops 3 and Advanced Warfare, Infinite Warfare, World War 2. They are basically just supply drops, and you pay the same amount from them, and you can earn them by playing. And there's a video shot you can get from them, which I will let play now. So they are all of the things you can get from reserves, I believe. So look, here's the stuff that I've got. These are from the old reserve system as well. So yeah, nothing really much. I think I've got some yeah, from there. Is it? Anyway, so yeah, let's just get into the maps. At the moment, there is only the one map that's been added, because they add them all at different times, so I'll just go like over this map so you can see what it's like. This one is like a police station. It's a really good map because you can go on the roof, round the sides, inside. Just be any specialist. Wait for my go. These are some of my really like old classes, so they're not guns that I'm used to, but still I'm only showing the map, so.
Team Deathmatch. Special Forces, you are cleared hot.
So at the start of the game, you saw what happened. The motorbikes go off and the helicopters go away, and this big like barrier to stop you going out of bounds comes. So yeah, basically it's just all of this.
9 minutes good to go.
So this is the main room, really. Some chairs, and you can go up there. Show you that in a minute. Through here, it's just a room, really. Like, see inside, it's really like well detailed. This is obviously like they keep all the guns and the armor. And it's set in LA. This is the cafeteria. You can see by the writing on the wall. There's chairs, some food, bins. It's where you order the food. And if you come around here, you can go upstairs to get onto the roof. And you can smash your way through here and either look down or jump down. There's my shadow. Through here, there's just like a camping spot, really. Like, they always have two spots where people snipe from. There's one over there and one here. This part just leads back down to the back where we spawn off. And there's like sideways that you can go around. Nice garden area. Here's the other building that you can go in. This one's caught on fire. And there's windows here. You can do a jump over to this one. And this is just more of the roof area. And this is where I believe the other side spawned. And that just leads back into the cafeteria. And there's just another sideway around there. And you can also jump through these, I believe. Yeah. You can destroy all the glass windows. And then there's one just here as well. And that's basically it for this map, except like another sideway.
Throwing 9 bang.
And that's basically the whole map there. So yeah, that's it for this video. So thank you for watching. Make sure to hit the like button if you liked the video, and subscribe because it will really help. So thanks for watching this video, and I shall see you in the next one. Bye.